It was a boisterous welcome at the Home for Life Animal Sanctuary when seven dogs arrived in the past couple of weeks from Kabul to Star Prairie, Wisconsin.
They're adapting well. Some were a little timid, so just getting them used to being around people, being on a leash, just things like that.
There were so many things these pups had to adjust to. But at Home for Life, where they will live out the rest of their days, the staff are just happy to be a small part of a bigger picture.
We've all seen the news, you know, what's going on over there, and it's very unfortunate. But it's also fortunate that we can take in some of these pups and give them a chance. Lisa, our director, she has contacts, you know, throughout the world where she works with multiple organizations to just make a difference.
Just across the St. Croix, someone else from Kabul isn't being so subtle about what she wants.
She was very shut down. She just kind of laid there. She came in with another one that was even more shut down and more scared. But once they've kind of gotten into their homes and settled in and had great fosters, they've really come a long way in their personalities, haven't you, baby girl?
Bluebell came in under No Dog Left Behind, initially as a stray with a broken leg. Vetting coordinator Kara Sneermeyer says, yeah, Bluebell only has three legs, but so what?
She's not broken at all, but she does need a family that's gonna understand that she's got only three legs and she's not gonna be able to go on 10-mile hikes, but she does sure like a good walk in the afternoon. And I think that just somebody that wants to keep showing, watching her grow and helping her build her confidence.
Bluebell's foster mom, Megan Fothery, says she's hoping Bluebell's new family will be patient.
Just willing to kind of be curious about her and help her discover what works for her and what doesn't. You know, it's a very different life here than her previous life. And so I feel like learning lots of new things and taking in lots of new information.
Both Nearmeyer and Fothery say they are aware of the ongoing tragedy in Afghanistan, so they're helping in the best way they know how.
For somebody that is heartbroken about what's going on there and knowing how privileged we are here, and I wish we as a nation could talk about it more and be able to pitch in more, and realize there are people and dogs and cats and other animals that are still there with no voice.
And the best way they know how to get the word out there is to have more fosters, they said. And right now, they said they're working to get more dogs brought over from Afghanistan. So more dogs would mean more fosters needed until they find forever homes.